Alright, community policing is as fictitious as the badge numbers that cops will tell you that they have. Okay? It's like, I could walk around, I should go for a regular walk and call it a citizen patrol if I stop somebody and try to talk to them about, I don't know, throwing their cigarette on the sidewalk or something. I'm on a citizen patrol, alright? I'll just kind of throw out that word as something that makes it sound like, you know, my approach is official, all right? Or you could even compare it to somebody who when they're about to punch another person exclaims, "Don't hit me." You know, if you want to have a good defense against assault and battery, you just yell, "Don't hit me," as you're about to hit somebody else, all right? And that'll help clear the way a little bit as a better defense if you get into a fight with somebody, because it sounds more like you're protecting yourself by doing that, all right? When these cops do this citizen patrol stuff, like, for me, I just experienced a couple nights ago where the guy said he was doing the citizen patrol, but it was more than that, okay? He was giving me a directive to get the heck out of this spot that I was parked and do not sleep in my car in this spot, all right? That's a directive. That's no citizen patrol, just trying to see how people are doing out there and conversating with them and all that. No, he's doing his orders, all right? He's enforcing some kind of a law, I hope. You know, a lot of these cops like to use their own personal preferences and make their fashion statements and things that they believe to be normal behavior. They're the deciders on what's normal behavior and what's not normal behavior. And the most normal behavior has to be the most profitable one for them. It can't be the one that they feel is losing them money, like such as homelessness. You know, if this person's not living in a home and paying rent or making tax payments for property tax to the city, then that's not normal. That's a mental illness, all right? And they're enforcing that. And the community patrol that they call it is more of a fact-finding it's an investigation. It's just another way of calling it an investigation. And then making that conclusion, arrive at a conclusion that they need to make a directive, all right? We can't have this stain on the society visible in this spot. Why don't you go ahead and move, and hopefully we won't get any other complaints. They probably got a complaint. You know, he called it a citizen patrol. He could have, maybe he didn't get a complaint. Maybe he just did see my car parked in the spot. I asked him if I was too close to the fire hydrant. He didn't care about that. I don't think he even gave a response. He's like, "No, that's not the issue here. it's not about me being too close to the fire hydrant. They don't care about that type of thing." There was the bigger issue of you know, he clearly saw I was living in my car. So it's all comes down to the same type of thing, you know, community patrol. Community patrol comes down to find out if this person has a warrant on them, make them jump for you, make them disappear, okay? I understand that's how a lot of poor people were handled back in the old days. You make them disappear, all right? Push them around, but we're trying to be more politically friendly these days, All right, you know, they won't chop off my head like they might do with like a Middle Eastern country.